In this video, I'm going to show you how you can add a wrap effect to any image, text, logo, or anything of your choice.
And now, let's get started. So, first thing I want to do is to import the images. So, I'm going to click right here and click on Photo Library. And here we have the image which we'll be using in this video. So basically, you're going to need two sets of image. The first one being the base image, which will have the texture or the wrap effect to it. And the second one being the image which you want to apply the effect on. So for me, I'm going to use this one as a reference. While this image, I will give it to you so you can download down in the description. So let's just open this one first. Now we have it in our space. So the next thing to do is to import our image. So let's click right here. We're gonna click here and then photo layer in photo library. So now you can pick whatever image you want to use. You can pick a logo, a text, or your own image. So I'm going to use this one as a reference and I'll click on add. And here we have it. So you can position it wherever you want to. You can make it bigger to cover the whole, or you can just use a portion. So for reference sake, I'm going to leave mine like this and I'm going to click on OK. And yeah, we are almost done. So what's left is to apply the warp effect to it. So to do that, we're going to click right here. We're going to make a copy of this base layer and we overlay it on top. So we don't want to copy the entire thing, we just want the area around this subject. So let's undo that. So what we want to do is to click here, make this layer active. We want to select around this layer. So to select around this layer, we click right here and then layer, and then select pieces. So click on select pieces. As you can see, the area is being selected all through. So now what to do is to come back here and then click on our fabric layer, and from there we can click right here and then layer from selection. So we hit done. Now we can take this to the top. We're going to need another copy of it, so let's just duplicate it. So come here and then duplicate layer. So once you're done, you hit done. So we're going to need one at a time. So first of all, let's turn off the first one and make the second one active. So what we want to do next, we want to apply some highlights and shadows to it. So this one will be for the highlights, while the second one will be for the shadow. So you'll see what I mean in a second. So let's turn this back on. We'll click on effects, then threshold. As you can see, we have a shade of black and white. So we're going to need either the white face or the black face. So let's just pick up the white face. So which means we're going to take this black to 0%. And as you can see, we have only the white area, which means the highlight. So now let's work on this to make it look better. So I'm going to smoothness. I'm going to increase that to a point which I think can look more right. Then let me see what threshold can do. If I increase it or reduce it. I think it's better when I increase it. So, alright, I think this one looks fine. Once we apply the shadows to it, it's going to look even better. So let's just click OK. Alright. As you can see, the selection is still active, so don't cancel the selection. So let's come over here and click on this one, which will be for the shadows. So make it on, click on FS, and then threshold. So this time we want the shadows, so we're going to take down this one and then click on this one and bring it back up. So let's work on the threshold as well. So I'm going to take this one really really low. And yeah, I think this one looks alright. So let's try and see for the smoothness. Okay, I think it's fine. So once you are done, you can click OK. And yeah, this is pretty much it. As you can see, it looks really really cool. So this is how you can apply a warp effect to a logo, a text, or pretty much anything you like. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye bye.